Namaste to all. I, Sangeeta Bhattar, welcome you all to our Divine Healing Channel. And so today in this video, I am going to give messages for 2021. Yes, messages of 2021. All these messages which I am going to say in this video are from the angels, archangels, ascended masters, my Guruji, Himalayan saints, and all the higher beings. So I was just sitting and thinking to make a video for 2021, and I was just thinking what messages I should be giving out to all the people and for the whole world and the society. And there where the angels came in, and they came in and they told me to meditate. They asked me to meditate and told me that all the higher beings, you know, like they have messages for all the people, for everybody around the globe. And so I listened to their guidance and I have meditated. Yes, I have meditated, and you know, like all these messages, what I'm going to say is from all these higher beings, from these angels, archangels, ascended masters. This year brings a lot of negativity and fear energy around the globe. Due to this, mostly it has impacted a human beings a lot. Does not matter to which race, which country, which religion, but it's impacted as a globally to all the human beings. And right now, so many people are going into stress, anxiety, depression, and there are so many who are really, really scared. They are very much scared, and they are scared to death. Yeah, so this year has impacted and bring a lot of negativity energy and a lot of negativity within so many people. This is a very crucial period because there's a lot of shifting happening in Mother Earth. Yes, there's a lot of shifting happening in Mother Earth. And so when the shifting is happening, people who are well grounded will be less impacted than the people who are not well grounded. So what do you mean by well grounded? Well grounded means, you know, like these people are well balanced. They can balance themselves in each and every energy, and it does not matter whatever shifting is happening, because they are doing meditation regularly, they are doing prayers regularly. Also, they must be practicing one or other way or form of spirituality. So for these people, you know, like of course they are going to impact it, but not that much as other people are impacted. Another reason this situation also arises to teach all the human beings a lesson. Yes, it has also arrived to teach us a lesson that this earth does not belong to us only. We have to share with all the other animals and other beings which are on this earth. You know, like being a human being, I think we become a little bit more selfish, and you know, we have acquired most of the earth. And you know, like I think that's another reason where the shift is happening, and you know, like it has impacted mostly to us on the human being. Now, you know, like people are more into technical things and they like technology. So yeah, technology is good, but it's a blessing as well it curse too, right? And that's what we are experiencing right now. The technology is good, but it's good also and it's bad also. It depends if we are using it wisely or, you know, like we are using for disasters. This is a lesson for us, and which has come to taught us that yeah, technology is good if it's being used for a good purpose or good cause. But sometimes, you know, like this thing of things also turn around, and you know, now we all are suffering. Ever since this pandemic has happened, more and more people are now doubting towards the God. Yes, you know, like because now, so this virus has impacted so many people, and you know, like every single day now we are hearing that it is rising. Of course, they are making the vaccine, but we do not know how it's going to take, right? And so you know, like in the last, when we do not have any hope, where do we go? We go to the God, we do prayers, right? So now, because of this pandemic, you know, like more and more people are diverting toward the spirituality, diverting towards the God, and you know, like praying to God every single day. We are so involved and got busy in our daily life that, you know, like most of us even do not have time, two minutes time to pray to God. Yes, we do not have time to pray to God for 2 minutes. We also were so busy that we even did not have time for our loved ones. Yeah, we were so busy and hooked up in our work, we didn't even have a time for our loved ones. You know, like we take it everybody for granted. And this pandemic is here and has taught us everybody a lesson. Yes, it's a big, huge lesson for all of us. So we as a family are coming together and staying strong and spending time together. So, you know, this is also, so this is one thing, I think I will take it in a positive way that yeah, this good, at least something good has happened. So this year has impacted us a lot, and I know that we won't be able to forget this 2020. So for those who have lost their family members or their friends, I'm really very sorry, guys, and my deepest condolence for all of you, and my prayers for all of you reaching out to you. And I just pray to God, angels, that you know they give you strength and to face the situation and to overcome the grief of your family. So for 2021, of course, this virus slowly and gradually going to go away in 2021. But the after effect of this virus is going to impact so many people in so many different ways. Yes, you heard me right. It has already impacted, but afterwards it's going to impact a lot all the human beings. And so for 2021, you know, like these angels, archangels, the ascended masters want you to work on yourself first. Yes, they want you to work on yourself, go within yourself first. And you have to bring a change within yourself. Yes, we all have to bring a change within ourselves. There will we get the result for the resolutions. You know, like why change is not happening, why we are not able to keep up the resolutions, why we are not able to do something what we really wanted to do, because we are not able to bring a change within ourselves. Yes, you know, like I heard people saying, oh, you know, like my life would be much, much better if he or she will change. But is that so? No, I don't think so. When you change yourself, you will see that world around you change, people around you change. So first, it has to begin within us, right? Charity begins from the home. Same way, the change, a small change can change your life and will bring a tremendous of change in your life, guys. So the first step they want you to do is to do meditations. Yes, meditations, you heard me right. And you know, like most of you must be thinking, oh my God, meditations, I do not even have time for 5 minutes. Of course, no one has time, but we have to take our time. So you know, like I'll just give you an example that if you really get sick, right, and doctor asked you to rest, so still you're going to go to work? No, you're going to rest, right? So now it's your choice. You wanted to wait till you get sick, or you wanted to do meditation and you won't get sick. And this is something to help yourself, right? So it's going to help yourself out. It's not for other people, but it's for yourself. And no matter how busy we are, we have to take out time, because it's going to help us. So for meditation, what you have to do, you have to sit down in a quiet place. It can be anywhere at your home, or maybe if you can go out in nature, you can go out also, but the place has to be very peaceful. Why I'm saying it's peaceful, because if you haven't done meditation, a little bit of disturbance is going to disturb you. That's the reason you have to sit down in a quiet place, then you know, sit in a comfortable position. So after you sit down in a comfortable position, you know, I would recommend to put your phone on silent. If possible, if you can turn it off, that's really well and good. But if not, put your phone on the silent. Then, you know, turn on any meditation music of your choice. Now, you know, there's so many different musics that are available online. So you can put on that music. You can close your eyes and concentrate on your breathing. Yes, you can close your eyes and concentrate on your breathing. And count of five, one has to breathe in, and count of five, one has to breathe out. That's the one way to start meditation. So people who have never experienced meditation or never done meditation, for you guys, it might take a little bit time. Slowly and gradually, when you keep on practicing it every single day, you will be able to go into deeper and deeper meditations. And I would recommend you not eventually to start it with 1 hour. Yeah, it is, you know, 1 hour you won't be able to sit. So what you can do, you can start for 15 minutes. Yes, you can put a timer for 15 minutes. So after putting your music, take a deep breath, and you have to count in your head 1, 2, 3. So on count of five, one has to breathe in, and on count of five, one has to breathe out. So once when to start going into meditation state, you have to be very, very careful about all the thoughts coming to your mind. Yes, all the thoughts coming to your mind, one has to be very careful that all these thoughts which are coming are positive or negative. So if your thoughts are a little bit negative, you have to start working on yourself. This is the time, this is the call for you that no, you have to start working on yourself a bit more. And how you can do that, like you can change your thoughts. If you got a negative thoughts, whatever, you have to pause yourself and you have to think, okay, instead of this, can I sit in the positive, and what is the positive word or affirmation I can use instead of negative. And you know, it might take a time, but this is a process. Once you start practice, you know, like every single day, you will become a habit, and very soon you will notice that you are already getting all the positive thoughts and no negative thoughts. Yes. So now I will be sharing a few tips or methods which these higher beings want me to share to all of you, which is going to help you to focus, concentrate, be at peace, happy, and you can bring your life back together. So people who are not able to wake up early in the morning, I'll give an example. Supposing you are getting up at 8 or 9, right? And you wanted to get up at 5 or 6. Supposing 6, okay? So, and you decided that new resolution for this year is I'm going to wake up at 6, all right? So, you started from the 1st January, okay? You know, like, I'm going to wake up at 6 o'clock. So, you start putting alarm 5:15, 5:30, 5:45, and 6. So, you know, like, and you just keep on smoothing the alarm, or you just keep on turning it off. And you are able to get up at 6, but you're not happy. But still, because it's your resolutions and you wanted to get up early, you just say, okay, I'll just, you know, like, do it. So you did for 1 day, 2 day, 1 week, 2 weeks, that's it. And then you are done. And then you give up. So anything which you want to form a good habit, one has to practice that for 21 days. Yes, for 21 days, every single day, without breaking a day, when you practice for 21 days, you'll form in a habit. Yeah, so what you can do, instead of getting up at 6, supposing you're getting up at 8 o'clock, right? So instead of getting up at 6 o'clock, first, at least for 15 days, try to get up at 7:30. Yes, try to get up at 7:30. And once you get used to 7:30, then go to at 7 o'clock. Yes, from 8 to 7:30 and then 7, practice that for a few days. And once you start getting up at 7 o'clock, then you start practicing to get up at 6:30. Yes, then get up at 6:30, and eventually you will get up at 6 o'clock. That's why I always tell people, you know, instead of going from 8 o'clock to 6 o'clock, try to practice half an hour early, half an hour early, and then you will get the result. So this is called a baby step. And also, you know, like before taking any resolutions, like when we take resolution, we start doing it from January 1st. Instead of that, start practicing from December itself. Because anything, if you want to make a habit, it takes 21 days to make a habit. Second thing they want you, that as soon as you wake up, first thing in the morning, you know, like say gratitude prayer. Yes, say gratitude prayer and thank to God for all the beautiful things you are having in your life at this time. Even we have to thank God that we are alive and we are safe. That's also we have to say thanks. So you know, like first thing in the morning when you wake up, just say a small gratitude prayer for all the beautiful things you have in your life. Third is to say positive affirmation. What you can do, you can write it down, positive affirmations, in your own diary. And before going to sleep, you are going to say that as well, because at night time our subconscious mind is very, very active. So yes, at night time before going to sleep, and first thing in the morning after you do a gratitude prayer, second thing is to say positive affirmations. Yes, and positive affirmations is going to help you a lot and achieve anything what you want. I will give you few examples about positive affirmations, what you can write. Also, all the positive affirmations are going to be in present tense. Yes, it's going to be in present tense, not in future tense. It has to be present tense, and it has to be with all the positive words. No negative words are allowed. So all the positive words, and it has to be in present tense. So now I'll give you an example, and I know most of you have this resolution for the new year, to lose your weight. Yes, to lose your weight. So when you want to lose weight, what affirmations one can use? So the first affirmation is, I am losing my weight in a healthy way. Yes, I am losing my weight in a healthy way. Second is, I am eating all the healthy and higher energetic food. Daily, I am practicing yoga or you can say daily, I'm going for a walk, or if you are doing any workout, but you have to keep on saying this every single day. So whatever we say in the morning, it goes into universe and it manifests fast. That's the reason you have to say it, all the positive affirmations before going to sleep and in the morning. So these were the few examples which you have shared about the affirmations. Third thing is that to meditate daily. Yes, they want you to meditate daily at least for 30 minutes and in the morning. Yes, why in the morning? Because I will give an example, like, you know, like before we leave the house, we make sure that our phone's batteries are charged, right? Same way, meditation charges. Yes, it does charge us and gives energy for us to go throughout the day. Yes, and when we do meditations, you know, like we are more peaceful, we are more calmer. So when we step out of the house, something happens, you know, like we can be well grounded, we can get more peace, and we do not lose our peace. That's the reason they are recommending you to do meditation every single morning. And all these things which I'm saying, you have to practice for 21 days. Yes, you have to practice for 21 days to form a habit. So whatever you practice for 21 days, you are pretty much going to form a habit. And this is what these higher beings want you to do. So the another tip is to do something nice daily for someone. Yes, you heard me right, to do something nice for someone. And it does not has to be like, you know, giving up things, but you know, like you can smile at your office. If you see someone that someone is not happy, so you know, you can cheer that person up, you can change that person. So these are the small things which you have to practice every single day. And once you start practicing, you yourself will see a big difference in your own life. So the another thing they want us to do, that every once a month to go out and feed the poor or the needy. If it is possible for you where you are living, people who are living in India, for them it is possible and they can do it. So if you can go and feed the poor or the needy once a month, you know, like it is also service to society and service to the people. And when we do this, you know, like you will see how much happiness you will get and how much peace you will get. This is the very most important tip. What they want us, that daily we should be eating highly energetic and healthy food. Yes, highly energetic and healthy food, because the food which we put in our body, it is also going to affect our brain and our thoughts. Yes, that's the reason we should be eating every single day a very highly energetic food. Another thing which they want us to do is to respect each and everyone. Yes, to respect each and everyone, especially to the people who are working for us, especially the maids and the servants which are working at our home, or the employee which are working in your company. So they want us to respect each and everyone and to be nice, kind and humble to each and everyone. So this is what they want all of us to start practicing, to be nice, kind, humble to each and everybody. It does not matter he or she is working under you, he or she is servant, but in the end they are human beings, right? They are human beings and we all need a respect. It's the saying that what you want, you have to give first, right? So if you want to earn a respect, you have to give a respect. Does not matter who that person is, he or she is working under you as a servant, maid or employee. You must respect each and everyone. Another thing they want us to do is to take a blessings of our elders. Yes, to take a blessings of our elders, if possible every single day. If not, especially if you are going for a new work, yes, if you are going for a new work or new ventures, definitely you should take the blessings of your elders. This is very important for each and every one of us. They want us to respect our elders. Yes, respect our elders and never ever upset them. Never ever upset them or never ever say any such thing which will make them sad or upset. Because remember, when we upset our elders, it is going to come back to us and it is going to get 11 times bigger and come back to us. So, you know, it does not matter how successful you are, but in the end, if you are not able to keep your parents happy, your anybody in your house who is already not happy, it is going to impact you a lot afterwards. Maybe you might be successful in your business, but internally you won't get peace. and slowly and gradually you will see the things happening in your life. So this is very important for all of us to practice, is to take a blessings from our elders. Also, not to make them unhappy, upset or sad. Yes, not to ever upset them. Because when our elders get unhappy or get upset with us, of course they are our elders, so they are not going to curse us or they are not going to say anything bad for us. But you know, like when they get sad, the energy which they emit, of course it's going to affect us. So this is one more tip and very important tip for each and everyone, that we have to respect our elders no matter what. So this is very important tip for us. They want us to start reading a books, a nice books. Yes, so people who do not like to read books, I would recommend them that at least try to read one paragraph. Try to read one paragraph. If you do not get time during the daytime, what you can do before going to sleep, you can pick a book of your choice and at least read one paragraph. So slowly and gradually it is going to become your habit, and you know, like you won't be able to go to sleep unless and until you read something. That's the reason we should start reading up good books, especially at night time before going to sleep. What you can do if you do not have enough time, at least read one page. This is going to help us a lot, because you know, during the daytime it is okay, but when we go to sleep, before going to sleep, whatever we see, whatever we say, whatever we read, it's going to go in our mind. People who do not like to read a book, I told you that you can read one paragraph. It is okay if you do not want to read a book, you can start reading positive affirmations. Yes, and it is also going to help you. But I would recommend that it's possible, try to read some good books. There are so many good books available, and you know, like of course you will see the difference when you start reading the book. Every single day, if you can do something what you like, meaning if you like to do painting, if you like to do drawing, if you like some kind of arts or craft, try to bring that back in your life. Yes, because I have seen, you know, especially women, you know, after they got married, they have kids, you know, they give up so many things what they used to love, they used to like it. So you know, start doing what you like, because once you start doing what you like, you know, you will see that your mood has changed, you are becoming more happy. So once we are more happy, you know, like people around us are going to be very happy, because happy, you know, just when we are happy, look at the energy, the vibration which you are emitting, and all this energy and vibrations are going to impact other people around us, right? So that's the reason they want us to start doing something of our choice, what we like to do. It can be painting, it can be some art or craft, whatever you like. There are people who like to do knitting, all right? So it does not matter, whatever you like, it just do it. And I will just say that painting and drawing, it does not have to do anything with the age. You know, like you can do it at any age. I myself have a nice coloring book, which I got it from Amazon long back. And you know, whenever I have time, I try to put nice color into it. Yes, on the top is a one positive formation, and then there is a design where you can do coloring. Of course, I'm not getting that much time, which I can do it daily. But yeah, I try to do it whenever I have time, because I love doing colors. When you see that you are putting out the colors, and when you start and when you finish it up, the finished products, and you know, like seeing that beautiful colors, of course, you know, like all these beautiful colors, you know, like I love to see them, and this gives me happiness. One more thing I would like to add up, that you know, like do not think that, oh, you know, like we cannot do this because it's our age and all that. No, age is just a number. Age is just a number. You can do anything, whatever you want, and you can learn anything at any age. Same way, we can also do the things which we like, we used to do before, we can also do it right now. Also, you can, you know, like maybe if you like painting, if you like drawing, maybe you can do it, and also you can help your kids to teach them also. Also, you know, like as a family, you guys can do some project together. So it is going to help everybody. So please guys, you know, like try to do something which of your choice, what you love to do it. Maybe it can be art, craft, whatever. Even, you know, like if you like dancing, you can dance, you know, like does not matter who is going to see, just you. You can put in music and you can start doing some dance, or maybe with a practice you will be a good dancer. So you know, start doing it from right now. So another thing what they want us to practice is to start writing positive affirmations and positive writing. Yes, but only not to do positive affirmations and positive writing, but along with that, one has to visualize. Yes, one has to visualize what you want. I'll give you an example. Supposing you wanted to lose weight, right? And you did all the positive affirmation, positive writing, you're eating healthy, you're even doing exercise. Along with that, try to visualize yourself, you know, like in a particular dress which you really wanted to wear. That you start visualizing yourself that you are really slim and trim, and you have a nice figure, nice body, you're wearing this outfit, and you know you're looking gorgeously beautiful. So it is going to help you to achieve that thing faster. That's the reason they want us that along with the positive affirmation, positive writing, we have to start visualizing that. So the another thing what they want us to practice is not to say any negative things or bad things for anyone. Yes, not for anyone, even though if that person is negative. Please do not use any negative words or negative things for that person. Because when we say negative words or bad things for other, it's an energy. Even though that person might not be able to hear you, just say, okay, you know, like I'm going to say, you might think, okay, I'm saying it in my hair, nobody even, I even didn't share it with anybody. It does not matter. You say it in your hair, and that's an energy and vibration that goes out, and you know, like it's going to come back to us. That's the reason we do not have to say any bad negative things to anyone. The last very important things what they want us, all of us, to be nice and humble to ourselves. Yes, to be nice and humble to ourselves, because you know, like we are being nice, kind and humble to everybody, but we forget that, oh, we also have to be nice to ourselves. They want us not to use any negative words for ourselves. Yes, not to use any negative words for ourselves. Instead, use all the positive words and positive things for yourself. I will share an example with you to make you understand. Supposing if you are not confident, right? So do not say, oh, you know, I cannot do this because I'm not confident. Instead, just say, I am very confident. I can do this. I am very confident. Another thing is that when, you know, like people around us, they say something negative about ourselves, and then we start thinking ourselves, oh, you know, I am not good enough, or I am not smart, or I am not confident. So do not listen to anybody. Do not listen to anybody. You just listen to yourself. And when you want to achieve something, when you want to bring a change in yourself, you are going to say all the positive, all the good things to yourself. Of course, you know, like you are not smart and I'm not saying that we all have to be smart and intelligent. Like if everybody will be smart and intelligent, everybody will be doctors, right? Then who will be the patients, right? Everybody has their own talent. Everybody has something within them. What is smartness? What is beautiful? Beautiful is not only from outside. Beautiful is also from something from inside. Smartness is not only just going to office and work, sitting down and working. No, that's not only one smartness. Smartness is also like cooking. Cooking is an art. Not everybody can cook, right? So that is also an art, and that is also another kind of smartness. You know, like communications. There are some people who can communicate so well with someone. It should not matter to anybody if you can speak English or not. But whatever language you are saying, that also has to be very good, right? So smartness is only one thing, but when we put all these things together, it also shows us smartness. The way you walk, the way you talk, the way you sit, everything does matter. If you have some kind of knowledge, please share with someone else. Try to help someone else. You know, inspiration is the must. Nowadays, so many people need to be inspired, and I am always inspiring so many people, especially to the older women. Yes, you know, because at this age, you know, they have started losing their confidence. I just heard that the kids say, oh, you know, like you cannot do it at this age, you know, it's better to just you focus on your thing rather than going and learning these new things. I would just say stop it. I would just say to young generations, please stop and inspire our mothers or inspire our grandmother to learn something new, or whatever they feel passionate about, let them do it, inspire them, help them. Because age is just a number. It's just a number. We can learn, we can do anything at any age. So this was some messages for all of us for 2021 from all the angels, archangels, guardian angels, ascended masters, Guruji, Himalayan saints. So they want us to focus on ourselves. They want us to work on ourselves. So when we start working on ourselves, will be more peace, more calm, and the world will be much, 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 much more better. So for 2021, guys, I wanted to wish you all the very best. for 2021, and I pray to God and angels that hope they blessed each and every one of us with a lot of peace, a lot of good health, and bring a lot of abundance and prosperity in each and every one's life. And also I pray that they helps this virus to go away and helps to get the vaccine as soon as possible. So thank you all of you, and wish you a very, very happy new 2021, guys. So till I see you next time, I sing the Patel, take care, live with lots of love, light and angels blessing. Namaste.